Good morning. I'm Sharon Russell, Onslow County Manager. Thank you for joining us this morning. We wanted to provide some information to the community in this time of stress over our coronavirus response. I know this is a very difficult time for everyone in our community, and there are a lot of people who have questions about what our team is doing to best handle our response to COVID-19. I wanted to give some clarification, first of all, before I introduce those today who are going to assist me, that Onslow County government is not the entity that has shut down any of our restaurants or businesses. We are following and enforcing Governor Cooper's executive orders. And I also wanted to assure you, I know that in the media yesterday, there have been counties that have declared a shelter in place order or have closed their borders. That is not something that the Onslow County Board of Commissioners is considering doing. I had a conversation this morning with Chairman Jack Bright. He has spoken individually with our commissioners. Our commissioners are not interested in having our borders closed or in having any sort of order at the Onslow County level to ask people to shelter in place. It simply is not feasible in Onslow County. We are a community that welcomes our military bases, and we also have geographically distanced municipalities in Onslow County, and this is not something that you need to be stressed about. That said, we don't know if the state of North Carolina will issue any additional orders, but we are monitoring this, and we will do all we can to give you the latest information as it becomes available to us. In just a minute, you're going to hear from three important areas in our response in Onslow County. We're going to hear today from Victoria Reyes, and she is our Community Relations Officer with Onslow County Public Health. We also have Sheriff Miller and Colonel Chris Thomas with us today. And you'll also hear from Norman Bryson, who is our Emergency Services Director. We have many, many employees throughout Onslow County who are working diligently to provide a solid response to this crisis. I will tell you that we don't have all the answers. We've never dealt with a pandemic in our area. We have dealt very successfully with some very strong storms and hurricanes. And as a community, we have the strength to get through this, but we have a lot of unknowns at this time. We wanted to come on today to make sure that you had the most up-to-date information. I would like to let you know that we still have our Citizens Phone Bank available. If you have questions about how coronavirus is impacting Onslow County, you can call our Citizens Phone Bank. The number is 910-989-5027. If you are at home and you're sick and you think you may have coronavirus, we ask that you call our COVID number for the state of North Carolina, and that is 1-888-850-2684. I also wanted to let you know that in addition to our Citizens Phone Bank, where we are answering your questions, we have also developed an assessment phone bank out of our health department. This is a group of employees who are now calling on those in our community who are waiting on tests and may be in quarantine, and they're checking on those patients and seeing how they're doing. So if you are at home and you're awaiting a test result, you may get a call from our public health department. Please keep in mind that our guidance from the state is changing daily, and it is a full-time job right now for all of our agencies to keep up with that guidance. We are taking this very seriously, and your safety and health is our number one priority. I also wanted to let you know that as of 5 p.m. today, and I'm sure most of you are aware of this, we will be enforcing Governor Cooper's most recent executive order. Many of you probably heard recently on the news. The most recent executive order takes place or becomes effective today at 5 p.m. under that order, in addition to restaurant eating areas being shut down, of course, our restaurants can still do takeout, and we encourage you to do that if you're able to do that. But today at 5 p.m., we will also have tattoo establishments, indoor and outdoor pools, hair and nail salons, and movie theaters, bowling alleys, and a variety of other businesses that will be restricted and closed down. We think that this is for at least a few weeks, and we will let you know as we find out how much longer that will last. We realize that there are many of you who have now been out of work for a week or more. We are very concerned about the impact of that in our community. We have now reached out to a number of churches and nonprofits who are willing to serve as distribution points for those who may be running out of groceries. If you are a individual or an organization, a business that can donate non-perishable food items for distribution to those in our community who do not have groceries to get through the week, we would like for you to reach out and donate those items at our senior services building, our multi-purpose building. And you can also call the senior services front desk for information about bringing donations of non-perishable food items. That number is 910-455-2747. It is important to us to ensure that we work together as a community to do what we can do to help people. We can't control everything in this current virus outbreak, but we do need to focus on what we can do. At this time, I would like to pass the mic over to Ms. Victoria Reyes, who will give us an update from Public Health.
Thank you, Ms. Russell. Last week, you might have seen our message from our health director, Ms. Kristen Richmond Hoover, who was letting the community know that it is important to stay home when you are sick. That continues to be our guidance today from the state, as well as our local health department, is please stay home if you are sick. Right now, most people who do get COVID-19 will recover without needing medical attention. So the Center for Disease Control does recommend that you stay home if you are having some mild symptoms, such as fever and cough without shortness of breath. If you are in those higher risk of getting sick, either 65 and older, if you're living in a nursing home or long-term care facility, have a high risk of chronic disease, which includes lung disease, heart disease, and complications, please feel free to seek medical attention, as well as if you are pregnant or you're also at risk for certain illnesses. So what's important right now is to continue to isolate, stay home, monitor your symptoms, and if there is a need, contact 911 and let them know the symptoms that you are having before our responders come to your home. I also want to let you know that before those who are pending results can get back to normal activities, they must be able to answer three questions. Has it been at least 7 days since you last had symptoms? Have you been without a fever for 3 days, 72 hours, without any fever-reducing medication? And are other symptoms improved? If you can answer yes to these three questions, you are free and able to go about with normal activities. And then we also want to encourage, please call your doctor if those symptoms continue to get worse. If you're not sure if you have COVID-19, the guidance is to continue to just monitor and isolate. That's going to be the best guidance, is stay at home if you're sick. Please don't be going out. Right now is not the time that we want to be taking risks.
Thank you so much, Victoria. And we appreciate all of the tireless work that our public health department is doing at this time. These folks are literally working 7 days a week, all day long, half the night right now, and really trying to do the best they can for the Onslow County response to this virus. I'm now going to call on Norman Bryson. Norman is our Emergency Services Director. Norman?
Thank you, Ms. Russell. Good morning, everyone. First thing I want to let everyone know is so far, E911, EMS, and fire services have not been impacted by the COVID-19 virus. We are still running operations normal. It has not impacted our personnel, and we're staying fully staffed, so we are keeping our services up and running. One of the things I do want people to know is if you do call 911, that we will be asking additional questions. And those questions are relevant to have you been tested or are you being tested or evaluated for COVID-19. This is allowing our personnel the opportunity to be able to put on additional PPE if someone is in the evaluation process so that we can protect our personnel and make sure that they're not affected by this virus. We also have activated our EOC, and that has been activated since the Board of Commissioners put the state of emergency in place. Now, this is much different than what we normally see us when we're doing our Facebook Lives with the hurricanes. We're currently doing everything virtually. There's only a few people here. We're not seeing the large room staff like we've done in the past. And we're doing this so that we can keep our social distancing and keep our operations running as well. The other thing that I have is one of the things that we are running into complications with is supplies, and those supplies for our medical personnel is coming in with gloves and masks. If we have any of our businesses that are being closed right now that has the any gloves or N95 masks, and I'm talking about medical gloves, that they can please donate, please contact Onslow County Emergency Operations Center at 910-347-4270. Or you can come by and drop those items off at our EOC in the front lobby. Those items will be used to help support our EMS, our hospitals, doctor's offices, as well as sheriff's offices, City of Jacksonville Fire EMS, and our other agencies around the county to make sure that we had the supplies in place to protect our response personnel. Again, if you have supplies like medical gloves and masks, specifically N95 masks, and you're not using them, we would ask you to please donate those and contact us here with emergency services. Ms. Russell, that's all I have for now. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Norman. And now I'll turn it over to Sheriff Hans Miller and Colonel Chris Thomas.
Good morning. Thanks for the opportunity to share some information from us at the Sheriff's Office. We have limited some of our access inside our facility to try to accomplish some of the social distancing that everybody's trying to accomplish these days, and some of our non-essential services we are delaying until this situation clears up so we can go back to normal business. We are taking a number of steps to ensure that our detention facility is safe up to and including segregating or isolating people who are new additions to the detention center for a period of time to ensure that they are not sick before they're put into the general population. We are doing services at the front door. We have a service window there where most of our business is taking place, so we do not allow people inside the facility. I do reiterate what Norm Bryson just stated. Please let them know all the information that you have about your medical situation when you do call 911, so our staff is prepared if we have to respond as well, so officers can have the protective equipment that they need. And other than that, we are running at full staff. We do not have anyone out associated with this situation, and we are responding as needed. We do take some additional calls now by telephone as opposed to going in person, but those calls that require an in-person visit, we are doing those as normal, and business is proceeding as such. Sheriff Miller? Mm-hmm.
We have a historical event that I think the people should know. We have a good team, county staff, sheriff's office, everybody working together because we have a common goal. Our common goal is to restore, get this over with, get the virus to go away forever, and everybody to be safe and healthy. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Rose.
Thank you so much, Sheriff Miller and Colonel Thomas. I just want to reiterate, I'm looking at the comments that are coming on Facebook Live. I know that some of you joined us late. We did not make any major announcements about closures The county is not planning to do a shelter in place order. The county is not planning to close borders. It simply is not feasible in our county. We have a military base in our county. We have numerous municipalities. And I will also let all of you know, we are talking daily with our folks at Camp Lejeune. We have key contacts there that we are speaking with daily. We're in contact with Naval Hospital, with Onslow Memorial Hospital, with our other medical providers throughout the county. We are also in constant communication with the municipalities here in Onslow County. We are trying to work together as a team to do the best we can do for all of you. And our law enforcement officers, our first responders, are working diligently to respond to your calls. Please help them. Please be respectful of the extra work that they have to do now and the extra risk they're putting themselves under to respond when you call 911. I would also ask you again, if you have questions about how COVID-19 or coronavirus impacts Onslow County, please call our citizens' phone bank and don't call 911. We would appreciate you keeping 911 open for those emergency calls. I would also respond to some of the other questions that I've seen that have been posted while we've been online. Onslow County government is not closing any businesses. We are not in the business of doing that right now. We are following Governor Cooper's executive orders. And if you have questions about what those orders can contain, you can go on the computer and look at the governor's webpage. They do have a copy of all of the executive orders that have come out of the governor's office if you have any questions about what is included in that. And we will be joining you again. We'll let you know when we have another Facebook Live event. We would like to keep being transparent. We want you to know not only that we have 3 positive cases, but we want to also highlight the fact that we have more than 80 negative results at this time. So continue to do what you're doing to protect your family. Stay home if you're sick, keep your social distance, and practice good hygiene and washing your hands. We appreciate all that you're doing, and we hope you stay well. Thank you so much.